Dr. Bhavin Ram, the Consultant Vascular and Endovascular Surgeon from Yashoda Hospitals, Secunderabad. Thank you so much, Doctor, for joining with us.
My pleasure.
Doctor, firstly, I would like to ask, what are the problems of blood vessels in the leg veins?
In the leg vein, most common things are varicose vein and DVT. DVT is a deep vein thrombosis.
What happens in DVT?
DVT, generally, patient will be having a leg swelling, pain, fever, and occasionally they will be having breathing problem also.
Doctor, how different is deep vein thrombosis from varicose veins?
Both are totally different things. Varicose vein thing is not a life-threatening, but DVT can be life-threatening thing. And patients can get DVT in varicose vein also, but it is quite less common.
What are the symptoms of DVT?
It is leg swelling, pain, local rise of the temperature, generalized fever, and breathlessness occasionally.
Well, doctor, what are the causes of DVT?
So, DVT or deep vein thrombosis generally happens when patient is not mobilized, either due to a major surgery or some bone fracture or back pain, and because of that, if patient is not moving, that is the main reason. Sometimes in 5 to 10% of cases, because of the extra thickness of the blood, we call it prothrombotic syndrome. In a young patient also, they can get clot inside the leg. Occasionally, because of the long travel, more than 10 or 12 hours of journey by bus or car in the same sitting position, or air journey by flight for more than 6 to 8 hours or 10 hours, that can also cause deep vein thrombosis or DVT.
Doctor, who is most likely to get DVT?
Most commonly, patients who are hospitalized, either they are in ICU or post-operative ward after a major surgery, who are not walking, they are more prone for this thing. Young patients who are having limb fractures or any bone, major bone fracture, and immobilized, they are also prone for the deep vein thrombosis.
Doctor, does DVT cause pulmonary embolism?
Yes, that is one of the devastating complication of deep vein thrombosis, where thrombus which has happened in the leg vein, that will mobilize from there and go to the lung arteries, and that can cause a pulmonary embolism.
How long does it take for deep vein thrombosis to dissolve?
Deep vein thrombosis or any thrombosis in the body, generally it gets results on its own over 3 to 6 months time. So treatment which we are providing, that is always to prevent the further progression of the disease and to give a symptomatic relief and prevent complications.
Doctor, what are the treatments we have in Yashoda Hospitals for DVT?
Yes, for talking about treatment part, generally there are two things. One is young patients, we try to do intervention like thrombolysis, where we put a medicine inside the thrombus and we burst the thrombus. After that, we give them the blood thinner tablets and injections, which will be continued for 3 to 6 months. So quite a bit advanced treatment also we are doing here, where we do the thrombus aspiration using different advanced technology in our Yashoda Hospital, Secunderabad.
Doctor, how to prevent DVT?
Prevention is always like when patient is in ICU, we give them the low molecular weight heparin, we give them the cough pump compression devices, which keeps the blood circulating inside the cough muscles, and it will prevent the thrombosis. Other than that, when you are going for a long flight or long journey, I would advise you to take a small walk of around 5 to 10 minutes after 2 to 3 hours of sitting position. These are the few things which we can do to prevent the deep vein thrombosis.
Well, thank you so much, Dr., for joining with us.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.